Hope everybody enjoying this stuff. My name is DJ Henrock, Barney and Clyde Productions. Getting ready to entertain y'all. Food's getting ready to stop here, sir. In 5 minutes, I guess my man, he ain't ready yet. So I'm gonna do something else.
Celebration. I appreciate seeing all the love, all the strength, all the support. But what I'm going to ask from everyone now is to have a seat because I have a special guest that would like to appear. Please. Everyone, please clear the aisles and have a seat, please. Thank you. I love you guys. Thank you.
Thank you, guys. I got a big mouth. I can talk without the mic. Everybody have a seat, please.
Wayne. And shout out to my homie, LaShonda and Mama. What's up, Shonda, baby?
But he's the hottest in town. I'm just waiting for him to stretch.
Don't be shy now.
I'm ready for you, baby. Introducing the best from the west to the east, Mr. Rito. Yeah!
What's going on? Cut the music, DJ. He didn't even give no fucking music to come out to. That's what we doing, Dwayne? That's what we doing?
We gotta do the introductory.
Nah, it's okay. It's okay. We good. How's everybody doing? Y'all doing good? Well, I'm only up here for a little while, so y'all gotta be quiet and respect me. This is a wireless mic. I'm coming to crowd and mess with people. So, you all right? You look mad as hell, man. I don't want to mess with you, man, but this is a comedy show. We about to have fun. You ready to have fun? Ready? I'm not, though. I'm not having fun. Because the thing is, I don't like being embarrassed. Nobody likes being embarrassed, right? Everybody hates it. I come here. I come outside. You know what I mean? I'm feeling good. I had a couple good shows and all that. I come here. I come outside. This one girl's like, hey, I know who you are. I'm like, oh, okay. You seen some of my shows, right? You seen some of my YouTube stuff. She's like, no. Last weekend, I seen you downtown wearing the same outfit. I'm like, hey, bitch, don't do that. Don't disrespect me. It's my comedy outfit. I like wearing this. Any Spanish women in here? I see all the beautiful black women. Give yourselves hands. Give yourselves a round of applause, beautiful black women. Any Spanish women, though? There's one? I hate Spanish women. That's why I ask. Because the thing is, Spanish women are too controlling. You know what I mean? They like to dress their man and make them look foolish. Like, you know, they make you wear the little tight shirt and the tight pants. But what really messed me up, they make you wear them Spanish shoes. You know the one where your toes curl up like this? My Spanish girl had me in the Spanish shoes. You know what I'm talking about, the salsa shoes. You know them shit that you make your man wear. I hate them shoes. It's crazy, man. Just got dropped off here by my friend. He told me he's not picking me up, so I gotta find a way home. You know what I mean? So I'm kind of upset. That's what's going on in my life. Anybody got kids? People with kids. Y'all got kids, right? Yep. Kids are bad. I got a 3-year-old and a 5-year-old. You know what I mean? 3-year-old and a 5-year-old. Now, my 3-year-old tries to do everything my 5-year-old does. You know what I mean? He tries to do everything. My 5-year-old's into karate. You know what I mean? He's really, really deep into it. So my 3-year-old thinks he knows karate because his older brother knows it. He goes and gets beat up by a girl yesterday. You know what I mean? So I feel bad. You know what I mean? He's in the back seat of the car crying. I'm driving home. I'm trying to cheer him up. I'm looking in the rearview mirror like, man, stop crying. You ain't no bitch. Matter of fact, that girl's a bitch because she put her hands on you. I didn't mean it. I was just saying it to try to cheer him up. So I get to the house. I got to talk to the 5-year-old now. You know, I got to let him know what's going on. I'm mad at him. So I'm like, hey, listen. Come here. I walk in the crib. He's sitting in the house on the coffee table in an Indian stance. He's just meditating. He got candles burning, incense burning. He just looked like, it's just crazy. My house stinks. I'm mad. I'm like, listen, blow some of them candles. I need to talk to you. All right? So I go and put the 3-year-old down. I go back in the room. He's still on the table, still burning the candle. I'm like, listen, I told you to put those out. I need to talk to you. He doesn't even open his eyes. He just, shh. I'm like, shh, you gonna shh me? Okay, it's on. So I take off my belt. I'm getting ready to give him the old fashioned. You look like you beat your kids. You know what I'm talking about. Took off the belt. I'm like, I'm gonna whoop his ass. So I take off the belt. I go to whoop him. He jumps up off the coffee table and he gets in a karate stance on me. I'm like, oh. Oh, you think you're bad, huh? Baby, come look at your son. Babe, come. My girl ain't even home. I'm just scared. I don't know what's going on. He's in a karate stance. I've never seen it before. I'm just scared. I'm sitting there just looking at him. He's looking at me. I'm flinching at him. He's not even moving. I get too close, and he flinches at me, and I drop the belt. I go to pick the belt up, and he moves it behind him with his foot. Now he's dancing around me in his karate stance. I'm like, you know what? You can burn whatever you want in the house. I don't care. My little 3-year-old comes up to me. He's talking like, Daddy, stop crying. You ain't no bitch. I'm like, man, shut up. You just got beat up yesterday by a girl. You serious? You gonna play with me? This kid is crazy, man. Y'all having fun? I can't even make them. I'm trying to make Tyce Butler laugh. He ain't laughing. I'm joking with you, man. Let me take a picture of him for you. Beat me up outside or something. That's just in case. I know what the fuck you look like, man. I don't want no problems. I just want to tell some damn jokes. That's it. I just want to tell some damn jokes.
that was going on. I had to get right for this, you know what I mean? Had to go to the barbershop, you know what I mean? Now, there's a rule. I was in a rush, but every man knows a rule. Man, you agree with me. When you go to a barbershop, every man knows you don't sit in the first chair, right? It's usually the new dude, right? You don't sit in the chair, but I was in a rush. So I go up to the club, and I go into the barbershop, and I sit in the first chair, right? I sit in the chair, and when I sit down, the whole barbershop just gets quiet. Y'all good over there? Y'all ready? I just want to make sure everybody's ready. So I get in the first chair, I sit down, and the whole barbershop just stops and looks at me. They're just smiling. They're like, hey, John, you got a customer. So when they say that, a midget in the corner that was playing checkers jumps up. Now, the thing was, the midget had the little tough midget walk. You know the walk midget do. You know what I mean? The little walk. He walked up to me, threw the barber apron at me, told me to put it on myself. So I'm like, okay, this is a big joke. I put the barber apron on, and he's just lifting the chair up high as hell. You know what I mean? High as hell. I'm like, this midget must be playing. This is when I knew it was serious. When I'm sitting in the barber chair looking down, the midget's looking up at me. He walks up to me and he goes just like this. What's he want me to do? Oh, he wants you to pick him up so he can cut your hair. I'm like, what? I'm sitting in the chair holding the midget at the barbershop while he's cutting my hair, just moving him around. Crazy. Crazy. That's why you never sit in the first chair at a barbershop. It is crazy. What else is going on? Fellas, I already said what's up to the women. There's a lot of fellas in here. How y'all doing? How y'all doing? Fellas, y'all good? Alright, we're gonna have fun now. I'm gonna ask the fellas a question. Fellas, you don't even have to answer the question. I don't know if y'all feel me just by the way y'all react. Fellas, don't y'all hate when y'all side women ask how your family's doing? Really? Y'all ain't got no side women? Who said we ain't got none? I don't believe that. You ain't got no side women? We ain't got no side women. Man, you lying. You lying. Player, you lying, player. You ain't got no suit like that. Ain't got no side women. You got no side women. Oh, man. So what's going on? Hey, y'all good in the back? Y'all good in the back? Y'all good over there? Y'all good over there? Shoot. We get up out of here. One more thing before I go. I just want everybody to know, because I'm going to mingle for a little bit. I just want everybody to know that, you know what I mean? Like, if we buy a drink, ladies, all the single young ladies, y'all ladies right there, single young ladies, I'm going to let you know. If I buy you a drink tonight, and you drink the drink and you eat the ice, that makes you my girlfriend, all right? That's my rule. That is my rule. I was in the club one day. I bought a girl a drink. She's drinking a drink. She's eating a cup of ice. You know what I mean? I'm like, okay, so this is my girl now. This is what happens to me. This is crazy. I never knew this. A guy in a wheelchair pulls up. He pulls up right next to us. My girl's like, oh my God. She jumps in his lap. She's sitting there talking. He's sitting there talking to my girl. So I'm mad. I'm like, how's he doing in a wheelchair just gonna take my girl? So I'm eavesdropping, wondering what's going on, trying to get my girl back. I heard her whisper to the dude in the wheelchair, and she said, hey, are you still a good dancer? I'm like, you dancer? He said, yeah, I dance. Then he asked my girl, he said, who's this short dude asking me questions? So I said, you know what? Why don't we have a dance battle then for the girl? When I said that, the DJ stopped the music, and he got on the microphone, and he was like, oh, shit. The wheelchair bandit has another victim. Everybody clear the dance floor. So they made a circle around us. So I'm like, okay, I'm gonna have a dance battle with this dude in the wheelchair. He can't beat me. There's no way this dude in the wheelchair can beat me in a dance battle. That's the way I see it. So I sit there, I do my dance. Nobody's laughing at, like, nobody's cheering at all. Nothing's going on. So I clear the dance floor, and it's the time for the dude in the wheelchair's turn. This is what he's doing. DJ, play the music. This is what the dude in the wheelchair is doing the whole time. You got the song? That's all he's doing. Turn it down. That's all he's doing. Keep it playing. Go turn it down. That's all he's doing. You know what I mean? And the crowd is going crazy. That is all the dude's doing in the wheelchair. So I'm sitting back there. I'm like, this isn't fair. How is this dude in a wheelchair? He's in a wheelchair. How is his crush? You got the crowd going crazy. It's because the dude that wailed him in the club was behind him doing this. love the music, man. Yeah, man. Y'all were a tough crowd. Y'all were a tough crowd. And y'all made me work for that. They made me work for that. They made me work for that. Y'all having fun? What y'all want to eat? Y'all want to eat? I got, the thing is, it's crazy. I got kicked out of like 3 seats since I got here. I've been disrespected. I'm not dressed to like, the way, like birthday boy, Texas. Like, how come I didn't get the memo on how to dress or nothing?
Sorry.
We good, man. We good. We good. But hey, listen, before I go, hey, I wanna thank you for letting me come out here. My name is Rito Brown. You can find me on Facebook under Rito Brown. You know what I mean? I do comedy shows out here once a month. I'm at our next comedy stop downtown. I wanna thank y'all. I'm gonna let y'all get back to y'all's party because it seems like that's what y'all wanna do. So DJ, let's get it going. Tommy Davis, you ready to party? Alright, thank y'all.
Yeah. my time. Yeah, I'm into the game, but y'all might wanna save the wet. Yeah, stay late, save the time. I can dance all day, I don't choose ya. Y'all looking at something like a true player. A girl told me that a man that can dance might could possibly get down with the tool in his hand. Now I'ma ladies, let me see it vibrate. Yeah, and when it's over, you ain't gonna need your back. Yeah, 'cause I'ma go make you bend your back low and about a real bad, just like the purple.
Back it up.
start it over, boy. Some of y'all getting it mixed up, let's get it right. Come on, we've been doing this for a long time. This ain't nothing new, let's go.
Somebody told me just let the music come from my soul, so all of my people can stay on the floor. They got a brand new dance. You gotta move your muscles. Brand new dance. It's time to do it, stuff. Oh. It don't matter if you're young or you're old.
Here we go.
We gon' show you how.
I can't hear y'all. Facial game for the pain, need a new rep. In your heart and mind, never forget to say. Walk-ins are when you walk in, you know just one. Black on black, remember that it's a walk-in. Anyway, the shot list one, great form for fun. No hatreds, the summer's almost done. No time for sleep, jump in your deep and pump up the funky beat at the late. Fever goes off, you'll smash it and trash it. You're too young to be plumped in a casket. Just get your boys to bring the noise and just swing it. Everyone be able to sing it. Yes, I am. All these kids realize that I'm the man. 6'3" and made a quarter of an inch bigger than last year, but still a unique figure. Rob, bring a doc, no dinky and hot dog. No, that I'm a man that was born to have a mic on. Next to me at all times, ready to kick a line. Radically out of financial bind. That's why when I took the plans, I've never been. Skins on singing, between gates and green. Always said hello, cause I'm a modest fellow. Never try to play a superstar in the tunnel. And if these kids don't go by a record, they'll be has-beens. I'm just thinking, so we owe them to pull out your pen. Sign an autograph. Make a new friend. Just get your boys to bring the noise and just swing it. I want the people in the house to sing it. Chug Rock jumps up on the scene with a lane and a hardcore dream. The dream wasn't crafted to be pornographic. Pieces he started from the trip for skits. Don't need to hear all of that on a rap. The strength of my vibe which Chug from the map has a party. Seniority goes walking, the snap is autographed, plus gets up there. The dream on the game, I'm saying, definitely leads you right to treat me right. Peace.
Thank you. Thank you.